गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ अविनाश एंड माय सब्जेक्ट इज बायोलॉजी. व्हाई आई एम इंट्रोड्यूसिंग वंस अगेन मींस सिंस यस्टरडे अनवर्ड्स ड्यूरिंग द क्लास इवन आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ द क्लास आल्सो मेनी स्टूडेंट्स आर बीइंग एडेड कंटिन्यूअसली टू द ग्रुप इन ऑल द थ्री ग्रुप्स. फॉर देम आई थिंक दिस इज द फर्स्ट वीडियो क्लास एंड ऑलरेडी वी हैव अपलोडेड द वीडियो क्लासेस पीसीएमबी ऑल फोर वीडियो क्लासेस एंड वी हैव गिवन द लिंक इन द ग्रुप्स प्रीवियस यस्टरडेज वीडियोस. So those students who have admitted, who have come for the today's class, so those students after completion of watching this class, so go back to those videos also and connect the videos. And one more thing I would like to tell you before starting the class. In the groups, all the students are not coming from the English background. Sorry, that is English medium. So most of the students might be coming from the English medium and few other students might be coming from the Kannada medium, Kannada version. So for them, I think they may feel, so the what lecture or what teacher is explaining, it might be the little bit difficult. So they may think like that. So one thing I would like to tell you is that what we are teaching right now, what we are explaining, it is not totally the new concept, or it is not the concept totally related with our first PO only. So already you have studied these concepts in your high schools, 8th, 9th, 10th. Such kind of concepts only we are teaching right now. We are not mixing with any kind of expanded first few syllabus. And one more thing, yesterday itself I told you, this is the 9th chapter syllabus, that is a 9th chapter, biological chapter, that is a cell chapter. You have already studied that cell chapter. So that chapter only I am teaching right now. So for that reason, I am telling you one thing that, we are uploading the videos according to the timetable, and for one video class we are giving 2 hours, right? For physics 2 hours, for chemistry 2 hours, for biology 2 hours, and for maths 2 hours. So 5 o'clock it will be finished, and probably we are uploading half an hour videos, biology half an hour video, maths half an hour video, even sometimes that might be 20 or 25 minutes, less than half an hour. Suppose let us consider maximum time will be half an hour. If you are uploading half an hour video means, so we are given with 2 hours for one video class, for one subject. That means 1.5 hour you will get after watching the video. Half an hour you will watch the video, next you will get 1.5 hour time, extra time. So in that time, once again you revise the video along with pausing the video wherever you feel difficulty and make it notes. So what we are explaining right now, so make the terms, so write down the terms, the difficulty terms, and especially Kannada medium students I am telling you. So write down the terms, difficult terms or words, difficult words, and for those words, what you were calling for those words in your Kannada textbook. So match those words, and already for that reason I am telling you. So while going along with this class, please keep your textbook along with you. So right now I am telling you, this is the 9th chapter already, so already I have told you. That means while watching the video, while practicing on this class, so please keep a 9th standard, that science book, along with you. So it will be very easier for you to understand the concept. And one more thing, if you feel any difficulty in the new terms means, so please keep along with you a dictionary. So probably you will not get the biology dictionary separately. So for that reason, go to the Play Store, Google Play Store. So in the Play Store, you type this word, English to Kannada Biology Dictionary. Once again, I am repeating you, English to Kannada Biology Dictionary. So you give this a search and you will get some dictionary apps. So the first dictionary app what you will get in the Play Store, so you download it, download that one first, and while watching the videos, if you feel any difficulty in the words, search for those words. Yes, and one more thing, yesterday itself I told you, be interactive with the class, and you are given with the comment box, comment section is below. So in the comment section after completion of the class, if you are feeling any difficulty, please comment your difficulties, please give. We will consider it as our suggestion. Why? Because we are not seeing you properly. How many students are there, and which are those students their background. We don't know all those that is your histories. So because of that reason, I'm telling you, if you are not interacting with us, if you are not commenting, so it becomes just one-sided class. We are uploading the videos, just you are watching the videos, whether it is you are getting or not, we are also not getting that one. So because of that reason, I'm telling you, after completion of the class, whatever the problematic that you are feeling, so just write it in the comment box and send us. We will come to know. Then we will change our class according to that one. Right? I hope after completion of this class, you will respond for that one. Yes. Yesterday's class, just we have started that cell concept. That is a little bit of basic related to the cell. And why I have started the cell concept only means, as already I told you in yesterday's class, previous class itself, cell is considered to be the basic fundamental unit of all the lives. So life means that is the biology, right? If you are studying the living organisms, either those may be animals or plants, either those may be microorganisms, whatever it might be, if we come to the life is nothing but the biology, right? So in that biology, the very fundamental basic unit is cell. Jeeva kosha anta helthena adukke. So that cell we have started here, right? And here already I have drawn a cell diagram in order to preserve the time that what we are having here. So already I have drawn the cell diagram, and this diagram already you are familiar with. So in today's class, let us see how actually the cell has been organized. Either it may be the microorganism cell, either it may be the plant cell, either it may be the animal cell. But thing is, all cells are different, but basic organizations are, few basic organizations are common in all the cells. And here, what a cell I have drawn here right now, this is the animal cell, right? So let us consider the animal cell. Yes, here I have drawn the animal cell. So this is a eukaryotic cell. Why it is eukaryotic cell means it is having the nucleus and also different cell organelles, membrane bound cell organelles. I'll tell you later. So this is the eukaryotic cell. As already we know, we are having a five kingdoms: Monera, Protista, Mycota. Mycota means fungi. Mycota, Plantae and Animalia. We are having five kingdoms. Out of five kingdoms, kingdoms andre now samrajyagalu anta karithivi. Out of five kingdoms, first kingdom Monera, bacteria, all are bacteria present there. Monera, those cells are prokaryotic cells. That means cell do not have nucleus. Remaining Protista, Mycota, Plantae and Animalia. Remaining all the kingdoms cells are this kind of eukaryotic cells. Compulsory they must be having nucleus, kosha kendra. Nucleus irtavanta. So here, such kind of one cell I am showing here. Our cell, animal cell only. Because we are more familiar with this one. So our cell having all of these parts inside. So all of these parts, we will refer them as organelles, cell organelles. See, for example, if we consider our body. So we are multicellular organisms. We are not made up of just one cell. We are made up of trillions together cells. Lakh crore cells we are having. But thing is, whether all the cells are doing their individual work separately or they are working group together. Yes, the question, the answer will be arise. Most of the cells are grouped together and performing one particular function. So same thing is happening in our body. We are having many cells, some of the similar working cells grouped together to form tissue. Angamshanta karithim. Such kind of similar working tissues to form organ. Anganta karithim. Such kind of similar working organs to form a system. Organ system. Angayuhanta karithim. So, we are having stages in our body. Cellular, tissue, organ, organ system. But in all animals it is not true. They might be having some steps less. Whatever it might be, So here one organ performing one function in our body. Kidney performing one function, heart performing one function, stomach performing one function, brain performing one function. In the same way, cell also having some organelles performing one function. Just I studied in the yesterday class itself, I told you how our body performing one function by one organ. In the same way, cell is one body. It is a micro body, small body. Cell is one body. That body performing one function because of the these parts in the cell. So because of that reason, we have to concentrate what those parts are, what their work is. Yes? So let us consider cellular organization. That means inside the cell how the different parts have been organized systematically and what their work is. So nothing but I am explaining about cell organelles. Cell organelles are nothing but the organs present in the cell. If I consider cell as one body, means that body, if it is having organ, means these are the organelles. But small organelles, we'll refer them as organelles, cell organelles. Already I have studied those organelles. Let me write the list once. The first cell organelle is plasma membrane, the first one. Second one is cytoplasm. Third one is mitochondria, and next one is Golgi complex, and next one is endoplasmic reticulum, and next one is ribosome, and next one is lysosome, and next one is cytoskeleton, and next one centriole, and the major one nucleus. So here plasma membrane, cytoplasm and a nucleus, these are the major basic cell organization components. So if we consider the first one, plasma membrane, so this is the plasma membrane, right? This layer is the plasma membrane, the surrounding layer. It is a boundary for a cell. It is compulsory present in all cells. But thing is, some cells might be having extra covering on the plasma membrane. But plasma membrane is compulsory. This plasma membrane is actually a two membrane structure. That means it is made up of two layers. Say for example, this is the lining of plasma membrane. Imagine, if I split it, means I can see the two layers inside. That means it is made up of two layers, plasma membrane. So plasma membrane work is, it is a boundary for a cell, and its work is, it will allow the molecules to enter or exit. Inside cell, whatever the molecules are present, they might come outside, and outside molecules may enter inside. Say for example, carbon dioxide present inside the cell should go outside. Oxygen present outside the cell should come inside. So for entry and exit of the any molecules, this is the boundary. But thing is, this plasma membrane will not allow all the molecules. It will allow selected molecules. Yes? So here, because it is allowing the selected molecules, it is selectively permeable. Let me write here. Plasma membrane is selectively permeable. So this is the thing. Selectively permeable means it will allow the selected molecules to go out and to come inside. And the next one, we are having the cytoplasm. So here inside the cell, whatever the white background you are observing, imagine that is a liquid matrix material, that is nothing but the cytoplasm. So imagine a plate, this acts as a plate. Plate is having the boundary, and in the plate containing water, and in that water we have dusted some small granules, thermocol granules. We have dusted there. Thermocol granules are nothing but these cell organelles, or that water is nothing but plasma. Which plasma? Cytoplasm. Kosha dravya anta karitidvi. Idakke kosha pore anta heltidvi. Idakke kosha dravya anta karitidvi. So cytoplasm. Cytoplasm, it is a matrix of the cell. And this cytoplasm is having all the necessary chemicals, raw materials, which are required by these all organelles to work. And thing is, if all organelles are working together, means then only cell is present in living condition. If those workers are not working in the proper way, then the cell is supposed to die. Right? And next one, we are having the mitochondria. This is the very important one. Where the mitochondria is present here? Yes, this is the mitochondria. So here, the mitochondria means, and one more thing I am telling you, Kannada medium students, don't go for checking for all the words Kannada meaning. Say for example, mitochondria. In your Kannada textbook also, they are given as a mitochondria itself. And don't go for searching, it's a Kannada parallel meaning for this word. Just understand what that organelle is, what it is going to perform in the cell. Just. So mitochondria, we will refer it as powerhouse. Powerhouse of a cell. Why it is called as powerhouse means, this cell organelle giving power to the cell. Power means energy. So here, in our biology, energy means ATP molecule. So it is giving ATP molecule. So that we will consider as a power. Why that? What is that ATP? Adenosine triphosphate. So that is one energy packet. By using those energy packets, so cell is performing. Just like our coins, if you are having money coins, if you are having means, we can purchase any materials that we want. Just like if ATP molecules are present, are given by this mitochondria, by using ATP molecules, all other parts will work in the cell. So hence it is called as the powerhouse of the cell, mitochondria. And here I am giving just a brief introduction related to those cell organelles. And the next one, let us consider this part. Endoplasmic reticulum. So, just to split the term. Endo means inside. Plasmic means plasm, cytoplasm. Reticulum means network-like structure, complicated structure. So this is the complicated structure attached to the nucleus. This is the nucleus. Let me show here. Let me mark here. This is a nucleus. Kosha kendra anta helte. So this is the major cell organelle. Just like a brain to our body. It is controlling all the activities. This nucleus attached with this structure, it is called as endoplasmic reticulum. In a short form, we will refer it as ER, endoplasmic reticulum. And in an endoplasmic reticulum, usually we are having two types. One is RER, another one is SER. What is that RER? Rough endoplasmic reticulum, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. See, imagine on the endoplasmic reticulum, green colored ball like structures are attached. These are nothing but ribosomes. Yes. Here, that green color structure is present here. This we will refer it as ribosome. And Okay, I'll tell you though what that ribosome is, what it is going to perform. If ribosomes are attached to the endoplasmic reticulum, then we will refer it as rough endoplasmic reticulum. Why the surface is rough? Then imagine, endoplasmic reticulum means these are the tube-like structures. Many tube-like structures are joined one by one and interconnected. And one more is there here, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Smooth means, see here, this endoplasmic reticulum do not attach with this kind of ribosomes. Hence, its surface is smooth, smooth endoplasmic reticulum. And here, rough endoplasmic reticulum work is production of protein. Production of protein. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum work is production of lipid. And again, many other works are there. Just I am highlighting the important works. Production of protein, production of lipid. So, such kind of endoplasmic reticulum is present. And endoplasmic reticulum nearer one more cell organelle is present, that is Golgi complex. Imagine, this is the endoplasmic reticulum, near to this one here Golgi complex is present. Imagine we are going to use the saucer, cup and saucer, while having the tea. Saucer, this is the shape of the saucer, right? If I invert the saucer like this, above another saucer, above another saucer, above another saucer, so many saucers, a parallel group appearing like this, and this is the Golgi complex. And the work of this Golgi complex is, we will call it as, so once let me mark here, this is the Golgi complex. The Golgi complex work is packaging. See here, just I told you, endoplasmic reticulum totally producing a protein and a lipid. Those protein and lipid molecules will enter here like this. Those protein and lipid molecules will enter here. When they will enter inside, while coming outside, they are going to be packed. That means, it will receive the material, pack the protein and lipid, and it will send outside. Hence, it is considered to be the packaging center. Next one, major one. We are having a ribosome. So, these are the ribosomes. Ribosomes, we will refer them as a protein factory. Factory means producing something. What it is going to produce? Protein. Ribosomes will refer them as protein factories. They are producing protein molecules. That is the thing. And those ribosomes are either they may be attached to the endoplasmic reticulum or free in the cytoplasm. They may be free or attached. And next one, we are having lysosome. Yes. I think I have not marked here. Let me mark here. These are the lysosomes. And keep one thing in your mind. In the biology, if you are getting the term lysolytic, means breaking or rupturing or disrupting. Lyso means breaking. Zome means body. Zome, ribosome, lysosome. Zome means body. Lysosome means breaking body. So what its work? Into the cell, if any organism enters, say for example bacteria. Imagine, this is the bacteria entering inside the cell. When that bacteria enters the cell, it will damage the cell. Yes, it will collapse the cell. Hence, we have to kill the bacteria. To kill the bacteria, these are used, lysosomes. That means, imagine, water bubble, air bubble. We are having the bubble-like structures. So, inside the bubble, there will be air. Instead of air, it will be having some chemicals. What are those chemicals? What is their work? We have to see in the later classes. Just keep that thing in your mind. Inside the bubble, there are some chemicals. Those chemicals are killing harmful organisms. So before the killing, they are killing themselves. That means they are getting suicide, then they are killing others. Because of that reason, we will call the ribosomes as suicide bags. Ribosomes are nothing but suicide bags. And next one, what I missed here, upper side, yes. Next one, we are having the cytoskeleton. Not only cytoskeleton, endocytoskeleton. Endo means inside. Cyto means cell. Skeleton means that is the framework. Framework for the cell. Imagine, if the cell is present in this shape only, and the cell organelles are present at particular place, means they are held or connected by the cytoskeleton structures. These are cytoskeletons. All these are. So these are cytoskeleton. What is the work of cytoskeleton? It is a framework to the cell. Just imagine, we are having the raw coconut, tender coconut, elaniru. In the raw tender coconut, if you peel out the green structure, green surface, inside we are having fibrous. Yes, such kind of fibre-like structures these are, and made up of protein. Such kind of endoskeleton structures are giving framework to the cell within. Say, just one, imagine one example. Our body is having a particular shape. Why? Why? Because this kind of body shape is present inside. Endoskeleton. Asthipanjara. Olagiro asthipanjara namma tarane ide. Hangagi nam body ge ee shape bandide. The same way, here, these fibery structures are the concept to be the endoskeleton, endocytoskeleton. They are giving one shape to the cell from inside. Along with this one also giving one shape because of this circular shape. And another centriole, the cell organelle, we are having a centriole. These are the centrioles, box-like structures. So, box-like, imagine matchbox. We are having two matchbox. One matchbox in this way, another matchbox in this way, perpendicular direction, two box-like structures. The centriole's work is, it helps in cell division. ಕೋಶ ವಿಭಜನೆ. ಸೊ ಒಂದು ಕೋಶ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದು ವಿಭಜನೆ ಆಗಿ ಎರಡಾಗೋ ಟೈಮ್ದಲ್ಲಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಹಕರಿಸುವ ಒಂದು ಸೆಲ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಿಯೋಲ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ ಡಿವಿಷನ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಮೇಜರ್ ಒನ್, ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ದ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್. ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್ ಪೊಸಿಷನ್. ಸೊ ಸೆಂಟರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಮೇಜರ್ಲಿ. And this center, that nucleus, it is also covered by one membrane, just like a plasma membrane. It is also two double layer structure. And inside of this centriole, we are having a DNA, major one. We are having a DNA. What the DNA stands for? Deoxyribonucleic acid. That is present in a thread-like structure. So, DNA... Along with that one, it is having one more center. We will call it as centriole. This is the center. Nucleolus. This is nucleus and that is nucleolus. And DNA is the major material. So, this is the basic organization, how the cell has been organized. And if you want to consider one cell organelle, it will take more time for a detailed discussing about that one. So here, just I have given the brief introduction about the cell organization, how the cell parts are organized, and what might they work inside the cell. Basic idea that I have given. From the next video classes, let us pick one cell organelle separately. Let us see what work they are going to perform. And today's work that you consider as a homework. So homework is just pass the video. Just pass the video. Draw this a diagram and label the parts. And after labeling, just one thing, do one thing. Already you are 80 or 70 members are there in the group. And this is just homework for tomorrow videos. To start the tomorrow videos, just one thing, today itself one thing what you need to do is, just draw the diagram and upload the your diagram, or take one photocopy and upload to the group and send it to the WhatsApp group. This diagram, NML cell diagram. Compulsory, I will check all the members diagram while starting the tomorrow's class. I will check once again for all those photos. So just take one photo of this one, pass the video, take the photo and just you try drawing this diagram and label the parts neatly. And just diagram only. And draw the diagram and take the photo and send it to the WhatsApp group. Yes?